Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to study the urea cycle. In urea cycle, we will see the metabolism of proteins. We can see that proteins are degraded into amino acids with the help of salivary and gastric enzymes. Then they are metabolized into ammonia through urea cycle. But ammonia is very toxic in nature. So it is converted into urea, which is non-toxic in nature. Urea then enters the kidneys through blood and it is excreted in the urine. So we will see this part, how this ammonia is converted into urea through urea cycle. So we come to the first step. Here carbon dioxide and ammonium ions from the mitochondria, they react with the glutamate and the inorganic phosphate given by the ATP. All of these come together to form carbamoyl phosphate, which is the main precursor in this cycle. And it is a very important step, because without the carbamoyl phosphate, there will be no formation of urea. So this is the most important step. So what carbamoyl phosphate is doing? It is reacting with L-ornithine in the presence of an enzyme, ornithine transcarbamoylase, and forming the L-citrulline. So you can see this is this moiety, which is carbamoyl moiety. It is coming from carbon dioxide and ammonia, and phosphate group is coming from the ATP. So both of these combined together with ornithine and with the hydrolysis, with the water eliminated, the carbamoyl moiety is attached at this point of the citrulline. Then in the presence of L-aspartate and arginosuccinic acid synthase, again there is formation of arginosuccinate and with the help of inorganic phosphate. So this moiety is same. This L-aspartate group, this moiety gets attached here with the removal of water molecule, and it forms arginosuccinate. Here the attachment, you can very well see the attachment. All the moiety of citrulline is ditto same, but the L-aspartate unit gets attached here with the removal of this water molecule. Then arginosuccinate, in the presence of an enzyme arginosuccinase, it forms arginine. This portion is separated and this portion is separated as fumarate. So this arginosuccinate is divided into two parts, fumarate. This side is fumarate and this side forms the L-arginine, like this. So as you can see, with the formation of L-arginine, in the presence of an enzyme arginase, and when we add the water molecule attacks at this site and there is formation of urea molecule. This molecule is separated from this side. It forms urea and this portion forms the ornithine. Ornithine is again formed. It again repeats the cycle and it keeps on repeating the cycle. Ornithine keeps on reacting with carbamoyl phosphate. Then this step, then this step, then again arginase will form this L-ornithine. This cycle keeps on repeating until whole of the ammonia, which is toxic in nature, gets converted into non-toxic urea, which enters the kidneys through the blood and excreted in the urine. Thank you so much.